For lead, there are two main pathways in which it enters the body. The first is through inhalation, where you're breathing the air surrounding you, which contains lead particles. And the second is ingestion, where lead dust can enter through the mouth. Fortunately, there are ways in which we can minimize the amount of lead dust that can get into the body. If lead can be substituted or eliminated entirely, this would be the best scenario, as it eliminates any possibility of having a lead exposure. If lead can't be removed or eliminated from the process, engineering controls such as containing or using exhaust ventilation will help minimize the amount of lead dust generated into the air. To prevent lead exposure via inhalation, work processes should be performed in a manner which minimizes the amount of lead dust that's generated into the air. To remove lead dust that has settled on the floor or surfaces, use of a HEPA vacuum is the most effective way to minimize the amount of dust that is reintroduced into the air. Using wet methods is another technique to reduce the amount of lead in the air by wetting down surfaces before sweeping or during wet mopping. Lead exposure via ingestion typically occurs through contaminated hands, food, water, or cigarettes. Hands, clothing, and hair can easily become contaminated with just a small amount of lead dust. Removal of lead from skin, clothing, and hair cannot be accomplished effectively with just regular soap or detergent. Instead, a product specifically designed for lead removal should be used. To protect workers, respirators can be used within a respiratory protection program that will filter out lead particles from the air as the worker breathes. Gloves should always be worn when working with or around lead to help prevent lead from getting on the hands. Disposable overalls should be worn by the workers, or else their clothes should be left at the work site where it can be laundered. This helps prevent lead from being taken home and potentially contaminating automobiles, homes, and exposing families. Before eating, drinking, or smoking, hands, forearms, and face should always be washed. Additionally, precautions should be taken to ensure personal items are free of lead, such as lunch pails and cell phones, where there is a potential to recontaminate your hands. These items can be cleaned using specialized wipes to remove lead. Following these simple procedures will help ensure that workers and their families will remain healthy.
To learn more about lead poisoning prevention or NIOSH's ABLES and HHE programs, you can follow the links below in the description of this video.